Hello students, this class will continue our discussion on test method of analysis applicable to the fields. We have discussed two examples in the last class. Also, we have discussed how to develop this test matrix and also how to find the node matrix. L due to the applied roots, and also find the E matrix. Also, by relationship that K delta I is equal to P minus PL, we can solve these unknowns, that is the displacements and the unknowns in case of matrix method analysis. This method we have also discussed today, displacement method. So displacements are the primary unknowns. On the displacement, find out the member forces. Okay. Member forces at different joints. So we have discussed two problems in the last class. One is the hanging case where the moment is applied at the joint. One is the simple beam at one end. Now in the example three. Discuss that continuous beam where the support is sinking. You see, in the problem there is no load, only there is a sinking of supports. Support B sinks by 10 millimeter. Right? Support B sinks by 10 millimeter downward, and EI value is given in kilonewton. So either you can convert this sinking by meter, and then start calculation. Now let us go to the solution part. Now here this is your kinematic indeterminacy. So because the both ends are fixed, so at both ends the slope affects on the zero. So there is only two unknowns will find out. One is the slope at joint B, slope at joint C. So this is one you can take, or you can say theta B. As here the kinematic indeterminacy. So that is why he has found here that 1 and 2 is the coordinate. Now B sinks by 10 millimeter. So if B sinks by 10 millimeter, then what will the moments? Now it is sinks by 10 millimeter. So as I have told, because all the EI value is given in kilonewton meter square. So let you explain convert this 10 millimeter into meter. That is 0.01. 10 millimeter is equal to 0.01 meter. And the moment of inertia is also different given. So mark here. Moment of inertia of span AB is y. Moment of inertia of span BC and span CD is 2.5. And they are 4 meter each, and this is 3 meter. So you have to incorporate these I values in your calculations. Now let us go to that calculation of the fixed end moments due to the support sinking. Now when the support sinks, when a support B is downward with respect to A. So that means upward is positive, downward is negative, so there will be negative moments at A and B, that is minus 6 EI delta by L square. And here for span AB, I is equal to 2y. So now we can put the values here. Values can be put, EI value is 6000 kilonewton meter square. 6000 kilonewton meter square, and it has 2 EI, so 2 is multiplied 6 is the value, delta is 0.01 L square. This is all the values are converted in kilonewton meter. So this is meter, this is kilonewton meter square, this is meter square, so it will come in kilonewton. So this comes out to be minus 80 kilonewton meter. Now similarly, when we come to BC, this support is upward respect to this delta is positive. This is a downward region. So the values will be 6 EI delta by L square or VC to the point B. Now, if this is the point B, BC, and here it is 2.5 L. It is given 2.5 L. So we find out 6 E 2.5 I is been put here. Now 2.5 will come. Delta is equal to 0.01 meter. BC is equal to 4 meter. So it comes 56.25 kilonewton. So what we obtain? But you see, there is no any loading. There is no control CUDLs for which there will be fixed moments. If at all there will be some kind of loads also can be given here, then that moment will be added to this. We have done such type of problem, maybe in slow deflection or that if there will be some control here, some UDL here, okay, then the moment due to this load at this end and that this end is to be added with this minus 6 at delta. Well, if there is some load in BC, then the fixed end moment to this load shall be added to this value of the thinking of set limit of software. Here it is not given, so it is very straightforward. So find the values of the fixed. Now if you'll find out this, what are our coordinates? Coordinate is 1 and 2 at B and at C. So at B, what is the joint load? PL. PL will be equal to MFDA plus fixed end moment on BC. And that at the joint C, it will be only CD. So there is no other moment in CD. Had it been there some loads in the CD, then we have got the value of CD. So this problem can be another 3-4 problems. By putting these loads here and there, by changing the I value, by changing the support condition at the ends, the problem can be multiple problems. So you can practice any kind of problem. So in this problem, I can make 10 problems. So what can be done? You can say this end is hinged. This end fixed, this end hinged, both end hinged. Loads are in this span, load in this span, load is not in this span. So many things will come. Sometimes C also settles. Okay. So many combination permutations can be done, and you should understand the concept so that you can solve any kind of problem. Now as we have talked, we have discussed that the joint load PL will be minus 80, FAB is minus 80, and BC is plus 56.25, minus 23.7. Again, at MFCB, only 56.25. What is the PL? E is the joint loads, applied loads. Applied loads, applied loads, it is zero. Once you find P and PL value, next will go for the stiffness matrix. So now let us see how to find stiffness matrix. So you have to give a unity rotation at 1 and find out the force developed at 1 and that the meaning of your stiffness matrix. So you go to K11. When we are putting the unity rotation at B, then we will find out what is the moment developed. The moment will be equal to this 2EI by L theta A plus 2 theta B minus 3 delta by L. From this side also give from the BC. From BC, what will find out? We will find out it will be equal to 2EI by L, and for AB it was 2Y. For BC, it is 2.5A. That is also to be incorporated in the finding of the K11 and K21. Now, we will come to the 2. We will go to 2. Find it will come from here only BC. The thing will come from CT, it will come only from this. All are locked. We are giving a unit rotation, theta A, theta C, theta D, whatever you say, all will be equal to zero. Other kind of way. They come from only this C, it will be 2 EI by L, I is equal to 2.5 I, and the span is different for theta, and your theta B is 1, and all other are. So that we can find out. That's fine. See, theta A, theta C, delta, and 0. I'm applying unit rotation at B. So, 2EI for AB. So, this is for AB. So, this is coming from this part AB. This is coming from this part. Now, what is this value? 2EI for this span it is 2Y, for this span it is 2.5Y. Should be successfully doing the calculation, see the determinants of this span that will be included here itself. So, you can find this is theta A 0, theta 0, theta B 1, theta B 1, plus delta 0. Now calculate 2 2 4 2 8 8i by 3, and then 2 into 2.5 5 5 into 2 10 is 2 4 10 by 4. I by L into theta B. That means it will be 2.5 5 5 into 10 10 by 4 10 by 4, means 30 plus 32. So this will be 60. This is wrong. 10 by EI 0.5 to 5 into 2 10 by EI, and this will be 62. Wrong. 3 by 3, 4 will be 12, 4 times 8, 32, 3 times 10, 30, so 62, 12 by 62, 62 by 12 will come 5.1. This is how this is some mistakes, wrongly here and there. Please correct it. Minus 5.167. What is K21 now? That will be 2E, 2.5 I by 4. I becomes 2.5 because this will come from span. This coming from span, this it will be 2.5 I. So it will be 2.5 by 4. That becomes 5 by 4. Theta C 0, delta 0, it becomes 1.25. This is how we'll find out K11 and K. Let's go to the next step. Find out this K22 and K12. Now, in second case, all other coordinates are locked. Only you have the point theta C, where theta C is equal to 1. When you find K12, applying unit rotation here, what is the force developed here? Now when force developed here, it will only come from BC span. Span BC means near end is 2 times, far end is 1 times, delta is 0, theta B is equal to 0, you have only theta C is equal to 1. Now 2EI 2.5, so it becomes 1.25. It must be equal to K21. Find out, or you can directly check. Let's go to the second case. While calculating K22, K22 it now will come from both the span. Okay, see, by giving information like this one. Come down. What will the value now? Calculate the value. So this value comes from this comes from this this comes from theta d zero theta b zero your theta b zero b is equal to theta d is equal to delta equal to only theta c is equal to 1. That is the condition. So it will come the k 22 from bc to 2 times c theta c here also 2 times theta c and this theta v theta d delta all are 0. We are concerned with 2 theta c. So 2 times 2 4 n by 4 and here also 2.5 2 into 2 4 10 by 4. So 10 10 20 by 4 that becomes 5 by 4. So this is how we will calculate this thickness matrix from the basic concept. By applying a unit rotation, find out the value. Now once you find out the stiffness matrix, now your job is to find out A delta is equal to P minus PL, P is equal to 0, 0. PL we have to found minus 23.7 by 56.25 and we have found the K value. So now we can find theta V, theta C, that is inverse of this utilization. This calculation you do yourself. So that's nothing to be. Now we'll find out this. Once you find out theta v theta c, you'll find the member forces. Now what the member? MAB is equal to MFAB. Right? 2EI and 2EI 2 I by L. I is equal to 2Y. Theta v plus theta y L. 0, 0, theta b is there, and minus 69. Then MBA, MBA comes out to be MSBA minus 18 plus 2 into 2y, theta a 0, delta 0, minus 1. MBC comes plus 59. Obviously, it will be minus, it must be plus. Otherwise, there will be no joint equilibrium. It must be equal and opposite in size. So here you can find out the value from this C. There is a theta B, there is a theta. So you can find the value from this. Next comes MCD and MCB, MCD. So MCB and MCD must be equal and opposite. Because equal opposite, this is now plus 33, this is minus 33. Just put the values and get the all these solutions. They are this. They are the things found. Then how to draw the Venn diagram? That is not drawn. So you can see AP is equal to minus 69, minus 59. I will draw the Venn diagram. Here is minus 69. Here is minus 59. Minus 59 equals antiquity positive, and then plus 59. Minus 69 point something. This minus 59 point something. Minus 59 means it is axial anticlockwise. Anticlockwise positive here. Of 59 now. Now then come to C plus 33. So plus 33 means clockwise. Clockwise means it is negative. So it will be 30. And we are at D. D is equal to minus 16.5. So minus means anticlockwise. Anticlockwise is positive here. Right? This is minus 16.5 means the ax so here is plus 33. MCD, MCD is minus 33 anticlockwise. There will be minus 16.5 means the ax. Anticlockwise, anticlockwise means positive. Now, how will the diagram look like? minus plus. So there is no other load to be superimposed, so you have to find the diagram. So there is no other load acting, only the member end member moments. So those moments will be perfect in the middle. There is no load. I think now you understand this bending moment diagram. So minus 69 will come to plus 59 point something. 33 come down to 16.5. These are the moments are the members at the ends. Now let us go to the next example. The next example it says a bill of stiffness matrices or prismatic member AB in reference to the coordinates shown in figure for the following support: one end hinged, other end rolled. Hinged supports both ends fixed. One fixed, other rolled. These are conditions. Now one is your rotation, one is so displacement is taken as 2 and rotation is taken as 1. Problem, you assign the coordinates, so you can write down is here that coordinate 1 is rotation. This one is taken as coordinate 1 and coordinate 2 is taken as the displacement. So now you have to find out first stiffness matrix for this beam. Here it is 3 meter, here it is the 4 meter. Now this end is fixed, this end hinged, so one end fixed, other end hinged, but the stiffness that is 3a by a. A11 means apply unit rotation at 1 and find out the force developed at 1. Force developed will be from the left side, the right side. Both sides are hinged and the roller support. So the thickness will be 3i by l and 3i by l. So what is K21 means to apply unit rotation here. What is the displacement or what is the force developed in the vertical direction? Force developed in vertical direction. Force developed will be 3EI by L square. From this side to 3 by L square, from this side minus 3 by L square. So it will give, if you remember well, so if you given theta, what is the displacement here? There will be moment at here, okay. And also. This will be minus 3i delta by L square. This will be plus 3i delta by L square. Because one end fixed, other end is fixed. So one will be minus 3i by delta by L square. The other side will be plus 3i by delta by L square. 3i delta is equal to 1 because you will find out this value comes. Okay, so this is the first column, 1.5a minus 1.5a. Let us go for the second column. That means you apply unit displacement at 2. What is the force required at 1 and force required at 2? That is to be found. develop the second column of the stiffness matrix, apply unit displacement at coordinate 2, the force is equal to 1 and 2. Now, when you apply force here, unit force here downward, what is the rotation develops here? The rotation makes moment. The moment will be minus 3i by L square and plus 3i by L square. Already we have discussed. Theta, there will be a force in the direction of vertical direction, and due to the displacement also, there will be rotation here. Then minus 3i delta square plus 3i delta y. Now, if this is, these are these values for these moments, then forces will be pei by l. pei by l. That you have to find out. If it is 3i by L square, 3i by L square means anticlockwise. To balance it, you must apply it clockwise couple. After the clockwise couple, it will the clockwise couple. So this force will be upward. What is the force value? This is 3i by L square. P by L square is the moment divided by L. Force into distance, find out. So that will be 3EI by L divided by L. Okay. Well, on this side also, you will find out the force in vertical. That is also 3EI by L. Because here you will have the clockwise moment. So develop the clockwise moment here. Counter this clockwise moment, you have the anti-clockwise moment. Yes. These are clockwise, so you have to an anti-clockwise moment here. That will give you the value. So this is how we'll find out the K22. I by L Q. What direction positive? Now, so what is the K value now? K value will be, you just write K11, K21, K21, K12. Again, copy K1, K. This was wrong. This was actually, this was correct, K21. You apply 2 now. Applying force 1, find out 2, write K21, and it should be K12. Apply the unity displacement at 2, find the moment force at 1. K12. Right? So now this is your K matrix. We have found the P matrix and PL matrix. Now go to the solution. For solution, what was the thing here? To find the stiffness matrix. So now for the one end hinged, the other end roller supported, and if you are finding this value, it will be the stiffness matrix. Now here it can be any value, L1 can be anything. Now the second condition gives both end fixed. Now, if both end fixed, now what will happen here? Now, for this, again, one is the rotation, two is the displacement. Condition the same problem. Condition is the both end fixed. So both ends are fixed. Then you can find out that the here it will be 4EI by L. Here also will be 4EI by L. Rotations. The force required in direction 1 will be 4EI by L, 4EI by L. Okay. 4EI, what will the force? Force will be 1 will be minus 6EI by L square, or only minus 6EI by L square. why it is minus 6 pi by L square, we can find out. So if you remember well, 4 EI by L. So if it is 4 EI L means, here will be 2 EI by L. Okay. If it is clockwise, here it is clockwise, 4 EI by L. Here 4 EI by L, 2 EI by L. So there will be 6 EI by L. Clockwise, to find out its, you have to go anti-clockwise. You have to, of course, here will be anti-clockwise, and you have to balance. So anti-clockwise, 4 cos 2, 6 I. So, to find out the value accordingly. So, minus 6 I by. Okay. So, this is clockwise. So you have provided anti-clockwise. Similarly, other side will be plus 6 I by L square. One is upward, one is downward. So accordingly you can find out. So here the downward displacement you have taken positive. So this will be upward will be. So you can find out this value. Similarly, to develop this matrix for apply coordinate at 2. Okay. Coordinate 2 is vertical. Apply a vertical force here, unit displacement here. What is the value? Okay. Now, this will be similarly here minus 6 I by L square and plus 6 I by L square. So similar to this, you will find here k21 and here k12, not 21. K22. Now this, now here these moments are 6 I by L square, 6 by L square. So it will be 12 I by L2. 12 I by L2 and 12 I by value of the rotations are 6 I by L square. Must have the moment to find the value. So clockwise it must be upward here. Well, here is minus 6 I is doing wrong. Minus 6 I L square means it will be anti-clockwise. Minus 6 I L square means it is anti-clockwise. So what is the four here? What is the moment? The moment is minus 6 I into L square, is anti-clockwise. So because they are anti-clockwise here, so what is the force required here? The force must give a clockwise, which is upward. So 6 I, and here also will be same, 6 I by L square, or 12 I by L. And here it is clockwise. Clockwise. So 6 I by L square clockwise, so you have to provide the value. 12 VI by L cube. 6 plus 6, 12. You provide the value. So, like this, you can find the values 12 VI by L cube, 12 VI by L cube. That will be the K2. Now, so 12 VI by LQ and 12 VI by LQ will be your reactions. So these reactions are taken as the vertical displacements force required to produce the unit vertical. So this is how you will find out value of K2. Now 2 EI minus 0.3 VI minus 0.5 VI and 0.5 VI. So that will be your stiffness matrix when both ends are fixed. Let us go to the third condition. Now what is the third condition here? Third condition, one fixed, other is fixed. So one fixed means both are fixed now. So this side will be 4 EI by L. This side will be 3 I by L. Am I correct? This will be 4 EI by L. This will be 3 I by L. Okay. So 5. And here will be 6 EI by L square. The reactions due to this 4 EI L is equal to 2 EI L. And for this 3 EI by L, there will be no moment here. So 3 EI by L square. 3 EI by L square. This is minus 6 EI by L square. So minus 6 EI by L square means will be a clockwise. Okay. 4 is clockwise, 4 is clockwise. So for anti-clockwise, you have to take upward. Downward if you take positive, upward will be. Okay. Here it will be similarly. If it is a clockwise, okay. You have to take downward is positive and the value. Now, do you understand these things? Take an example. Here it is 4 EI by L. So here it will be 2 EI by L in the same direction. That is clockwise. So if it is clockwise, and the force required here be anti-clockwise. So the force be upward to make it anti-clockwise. So force is upward means it is now minus. So you have taken downward, it's positive. Similarly, here it will be plus 3 I by L, here 0, plus 3 minus clockwise, so it is clockwise here. So to make it anti clockwise, it must be downward. Clockwise, it must be like anti clockwise. So it will be positive. So this is upward negative, positive. So it becomes 8-1. Okay, 8-1 is minus 6 EI by L square. You have 3 by L square because this is 3 EI by L. Okay. So we'll take your moment as no moment. You take moment 0. So this multiply L is equal to this. So divide by L. So 3 EI by L square. So this is a similar fundamental for all the. Now come to this stiffness matrix for displacement in the coordinate 2. It will give the coordinate 2 is a displacement. Like now it will give a displacement here like this. So what is the force moment developed, here will be minus. Minus means anti clockwise. It will be minus anti clockwise. Minus. So to counter it, it must be clockwise. So clockwise means upward, here to downward. So they will give a clockwise moment. Counter this anti clockwise. So here the reaction comes downward. Downward is 12 EI by L. My point. This is 6 EI by L square. 6 by L is 6 EI by L square. So if you combine this 12 EI by L square, 12 EI L square divided by 1. Now for this case, it is 3 EI by L square. That is clockwise. Okay. So 3 EI by L square clockwise. To counter it, it must be downward, anti-clockwise. Okay. Clockwise, so 3i by L square divided by L, 3i by L. Combine this, it will be 12 i by L cube plus 3i by L. This is how find out the solution. Here the moment is 0. So it is a simple supported air. So you can find out the moment. So from the basics, you can find out this. Can find out this stiffness matrix for all the cases of the beams where the beam is both end fixed, one end fixed, other end hinged. So at any point in the coordinate, you can able to find out the stiffness matrix for a beam or any coordinate in the. So let us see the generalized coordinate, how they develop. For a case of a beam, so we can see for a beam how to develop a matrix. simplest matrix for a beam. So development of a beam stiffness matrix for a beam takes on what is the standardized stiffness matrix. We have developed the matrices from the fundamentals. Now let's see. Now 2 degrees of freedom, 1 translation and 1 rotations are considered at each end of the member. So take a member, so there will be rotation here. Here, rotation and translations are taken at each end as the 2 degrees of freedom. Hence, there are 4 possible degrees of freedom for this member. Hence, the result stiffness matrix becomes 4 by 4. Take 1, 2, 3, 4. So the matrix will be 4 by 4. So you give a unit displacement at 1, find out the forces at 1, 2, 3, 4, that is the column matrix 1. Then I give you displacement at 2, find out this forces required 1, 2, 3. Similarly, you can find a 4 by 4 matrix. The matrix that will develop here for a beam generalized case is a 4 by 4. Now here depends on you what you take 1, 2, 3, 4. According to the matrix, coefficients or position will change. So up to your choice. Which will take, you take 1, 2, 3, 4, you will take 1, 2, 3, 4, anything you can take. Accordingly, you have to develop them. In this method, counterclockwise movements and counterclockwise rotations are taken positively. Here, what is it taken? Counterclockwise and anticlockwise. Anticlockwise things are taken positively. Anticlockwise movement, anticlockwise rotations. So, in this derivation, he has taken like this. Now the positive sense of translation and rotations are also shown in figure. The positive translation, positive rotation, that is shown in figure. Displacements are considered positive in the direction of coordinate axis. Direction of coordinate axis. Elements of the stiffness matrix indicate the force exerted on the member by the restraints at each end of the members when unit displacement are imposed at each end of the member. That I have told explain. I want the fourth column. I will apply unit displacement at 4 and find out the forces developed at 1, 2, 3, 4. So that is called how to develop the stiffness matrix. Now, let us take a beam having I and J are the nodes. Now impose the unit displacements. Let us calculate the force developed in the above beam member when unit displacement is imposed along each degree of freedom, holding other displacement to 0. That means I have already told, explained that when there are 4 degrees of freedom, if you are applying 1 degree of one unit displacement at any of the coordinates, then other coordinate displacements shall be. There will be no rotation or displacement at the other coordinate. Only this displacement or rotation find other. So let's explain once again. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. When I am applying a unit force at here 3, okay, so all other displacement at rotations at these coordinates is equal to 0. Yes, regarding theta 3 is equal to 1, then your delta 1, theta 2, delta 4, all are. That is the meaning of this. Okay. Now, impose a unit displacement along y dash axis at j end of the member while holding all other displacements 0. Causes both shear and movement in the when you apply here, it will find the movement and shear in the beams. Now the restraint action are also shown in the figure. By definitions, they are elements of the member stiffness matrix. In particular, they form the first column of the element stiffness matrix. Let us see the figure. So we have taken 1, 2, 3. One is taken the upward displacement. So this is the coordinate taken. 1, anti-clockwise. 3. So these are the coordinates considered. You can take anything as coordinates and you can find out here. This is 2. 1, 2. Okay. 1. The vertical 2, 3, 4. This is the A member, and this is the J and K. So the J end, this is the K end. The member ith member. Any member having node J, K, and 1, 2, 3, 4 are taken. You can three to take anything. If they has taken, this is the positive. So displacement in this direction positive, and they should take that. Now what is being done, you see, now unit the rotation along Y and J. So you are giving unit rotation at direction 1, you apply unit displacement. Now it will go to up. Okay. If you go up and find out what are the force developed, direction 1, direction 2, direction 3 and direction 4. So first column will be 12 EI by L cube, 6 EI by L square, 6 by L square minus 2 L square. What does it mean? So when you apply here unit things, now this moment will be upward, so it will be 6 EI delta by L square, 6 EI by L square, delta is equal to 1. That will be 6 EI by L square. So because it is anticlockwise, here also it will be anticlockwise. And to counterbalance this anti-clockwise, you have to apply clockwise movement. So this will be like this. If this will be like this, then they will balance it. Now here the 1 will be 12 VI by L cube. 6 is first 12 divided by L, 12 VI by L cube and 12 VI by L. Now this 12 VI by L cube is negative because it is downward, so upward positive. The same thing being written. 12 VI by L cube, EIZ generated. So I put I. Now here the minus in the third direction. This is your 1. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. Applying 1, K1, K2, K3, K4. So K3 becomes negative here because it's. Similarly, if you find this second, in the second case, now go to second case. Now you apply here unit rotation. How the rotation is applied? It is applied anticlockwise. Now here you apply anticlockwise rotation. Go up. So it will take unit value here. So this will be 4 EI by L. Here it will be 2 EI by L. 4 EI by L, 2 EI by L. Yeah. This is the upward displacement given here. Yeah. Here it is given an anti-clockwise thing. So it is 4 EI by L. Here it will be also 4 EI by L. Anti-clockwise you are taken positive. So 4 EI by L, 2 EI by L. And what will the, it is anti-clockwise. So to keep it, we have to apply clockwise. So couple. So this must be a clockwise couple. So 4 plus 2, so it will be 6 EI by L square. It will be minus 6 EI by L square downward. Downward is negative. Anticlockwise positive. So now if you see your second column, the second column says you can say here. Okay. 6 EI Z by L square. So this is in the direction 1. Direction 2, 4 EI by L, direction 3 minus direction 4 is 3 EI by L. Now think you are understood. So now if you will apply here again, I will apply unit values at here. Okay. So that means it is up, it is down. Now the value will be find will be 6i by l square, 6i by l square, 12 by l2 and 12 by l2 will be value. Minus 12 by l3, minus 6, minus 6. Why minus minus? Because here it will provide unit displacement here. It is given in the exam. Basically, this support will be upward and this should be downward. So here we have the anti-clockwise. I will go in the other way. Basically like this. Now to give the unit displacement at here. So that means we are applying it clockwise moment. If they are giving clockwise moment, it will be minus. Anticlockwise is positive, so it will be minus 6i by l square, minus 6i by l square, right? Minus 6i, minus 6i by l square. So to balance it, you must have it. It's a clockwise, anticlockwise couple. So anticlockwise means you are providing your downward. It will be upward here, it will be downward here. Then only it will be anti-clockwise. Upward is positive, so 3 will be positive, 1 is negative. So it will be 12 VI by L cube, and that will be minus 12 by L cube. So you can see accordingly to the written. So minus 12, 1 is minus 12 L cube, only 3 is plus. All other are minus because these are clockwise couples, because we are giving unit displacement at 2. In the direction 3, so if you are giving direction 3, so with respect to 1, it will go up 1. So that means it will be clockwise. Now, in the last case, it will provide here, doing the wrong thing. It will provide here, like here. It will provide your here. Now, you are providing here anti clockwise in here. Like this one. Anticlockwise, it will be anticlockwise here. Okay, so it is 4EI by L, it will be 2EI by L. So these are the anticlockwise to make it a positive, you have to provide clockwise. So this will be reaction here, this reaction here. So these reactions should be 6EI by L. Now say this is 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1 is 6EI by L square. 2 is VI by L, 3 is minus. So, this is the stiffness matrix is symmetrical. So, this stiffness matrix is symmetrical, and you can find out this stiffness matrix for any beam. So, for any beams, this is taken 1, 2, 3, 4. If you all take this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, also accordingly, the kind of matrix. This will come similar matrix, but the position of this thing will change. Actually 4 by EL, 2 by EL, 4 by EL, 2 by EL, 4 by EIL, then minus 6 by EL square. So like that we'll find the value. So this is how the stiffness matrix of a beam can be developed. So the coordinates of this beam is given, and from the basic concepts you can find the stiffness matrix for it. So with this we conclude today's class, and thank you for attending this lecture. Have a nice day. Thank you.